Welcome back to the Morning Edition. Experts now say the economic prospects for the new year are good, and this despite the risks that abound. Mukeshla Pinder spoke to the chief financial officer at Fidelity and former president of the Bahamas Institute of Chartered Accountants, Gawin Bo, on the economic standing for the country in the wake of Hurricane Dorian and the government's borrowing.
How do you think we're doing in that aspect of things in terms of recovery? You know, the government boasts, for lack of a better word, that we're recovering much quicker than other islands that have had similar impact from such storms. But what's your take on where we are right now and in terms of what it will take to get to pre-Dorian days?
I would say he who feels it knows it. And if you ask the persons in Abaco, from Abaco, in Grand Bahama, from Grand Bahama, do they feel it's moving quickly? And you'll probably get a different sentiment. That's not to say that either one is correct. Ultimately, Dorian is going to show us that if we do things wisely, we could come out of this much further ahead than we were even before Dorian. Several of our Caribbean states, when they found the inflows of hurricane or insurance proceeds, the inflow of new investment, have seen booms in their economy because you have construction, you have new business enterprises. However, if you don't do it correctly, you could see yourself stalling. And when we look at the government has a tremendous amount of money that it has to spend in terms of the reconstruction effort, but it has to do so wisely. $1 million spent in the right way could translate into 10 million, but 10 million spent in the wrong way could translate into 1 million. When we look at the amount of money going on to the ground, we have to be innovative. So if I'm going to spend a significant sum of money, do I not look to create entrepreneurship by saying, how many businesses could thrive if they knew they would have pre-sales of several million dollars? And that's only to say that the government knows that it has allocated a significant sum of money. It should then be looking to say, well, how do I look at new opportunities for individuals by saying to them, if you come with an appropriate business plan, if you can demonstrate to me that you can execute, then I will give you the contract, meaning new persons. And then that will be a stimulus to say that person's moving into the island, people coming back to the islands, and then ultimately having commerce flow again. But I think we have to look at Dorian as what it is. Whilst behind every dark cloud is a silver lining, we have to be prepared to grab it by the horns. And in reality, people have to know what you're going to do. It's not good enough to say that you have authorities, committees, personnel being assigned. You need to lay out, this is what I'm going to be doing over the next time frame, so that individuals can feel comfortable that there is a plan and it is being monitored. And if we find deviations, we know that when things are not going as we according to plan, that we can take a different course.
What do you make of the borrowing the government has so far done to in light of Dorian? I think in just a few weeks, this month, the finance minister said they'd bring the mid-year budget. Mm-hmm. Again, what do you make of the borrowing, and what do you anticipate that mid-year budget may bring to the table?
You know, to me, borrowing has to be very strategic and has to be very purposeful. I have said repeatedly that I don't really have much faith in simply saying that I'm borrowing money. What I would like to know is, what exactly am I borrowing for? And when we look at it, yes, there's going to be a deficit, but where is that deficit? And I want specifics. So if you tell me that this is going to be infrastructure spend, I understand that if I spend $100 million putting in infrastructure, that should last me, in the absence of another hurricane or some major event, another 10, 15, 20 years. So I understand that there's a significant payback period. If I'm borrowing to cover salaries, if I'm borrowing to keep the lights on, that is not something that I want to see us continually increasing the borrowing for. And when we look at it, Rome wasn't built in a day. That's a common cliche. So we're not going to restore Abaco in 6 months. So do I need to be borrowing at the level that I am, given that I only have 6 months through to the end of the fiscal year? So I would like to see us lay out a debt borrowing strategy in relation to Dorian, as well as our normal borrowing. Because what I would like to see us say is, this is what we're going to be spending over this period of time. I don't want us incurring interest costs with money sitting in the bank. I sit in the banking sector, and cash is only idle. It's not making a return. So we should only be drawing down on our borrowing capacity as and when we need it. And we need to be very purposeful in terms of how we're spending it, with a strategy to say, how is it going to pay for itself?